Grateful to have you today. If you're joining Samadhi Game for the first time, you can go to samadhigame.com and download your free copies of Samadhi Game. No worries, if you don't have it, we're going to be able to put the manuscript of Samadhi Game, the manifesto of Samadhi Game, online, so you'll be able to read it right from your screens without having to get your own copy. But I do suggest, if you have the time, drop by samadhigame.com, find the link for the free downloads, and go ahead and download your own PDF copy for your computer and an EPUB copy for your mobile devices. It's really fun, actually, to have it with you. You can stop alongside a stream someplace and pull it out and give your mantras right there into the sounds of the babbling brook, or on the top of a mountain someplace, stopping, bringing it out and using it there. It's really quite fun to be able to do that. It has a lot of links in it too. The Samadhi Game EPUB version, same with the PDF version, has links in it that can take you to different parts of the web that explain the ideas or the words that are in this manifesto of enlightenment. So download your free copies today and get familiar with the language of Samadhi Game. What we're actually doing is we are becoming familiar with a language, an inner language of enlightenment. It allows us to enter the mystic world and draw that mystic world right down here to us in this world of form. This is the Tantra. This is the actual embodiment of the spiritual life into this physical world. We're trying to live it more fully in love. So that mystic Monday is a Monday of love. This first day of the week, this day when we all come forth from a restful weekend and share the love that we've experienced in the day as our work, as our sacred offering, as our gift given gone, we have this love to share. And when we share love, sometimes it's a little different than what the world is used to, this cross currents of the human ego, and love is without that cross current. And oftentimes it causes a little bit of a flux to have so much love in your aura. And so let's go ahead and protect ourselves with the opening pillar of light, the pillar of the world. This mantra is designed to encase you in light and protect you with the light and the love that you feel flowing from your heart this mystical Monday morning. So let's go ahead and go and get started right into these decrees, right into these mantras. This is the opening pillar of light, the pillar of the world. If you're using your own copy of Samadhi Game, it's on page 15. Come on, let's say it together. Sublime I am, Samadhi that I am, enfolding me now in that mighty, magic, electronic pillar of cosmic light substance. My identification with its magnificent humility and thoughtful creativity, so powerful and complete, that I artfully and magically alter every polarity with healing unity. Within this majestic pillar of light blazes that love as the violet compassionate flame, in through and around my etheric, mental, emotional, and physical bodies, effortlessly dissolving, consuming, transmuting, and reconciling the dualities of my human ego. Charging my world and all I contact with the tangible substance, living awareness, and conscious activity, the presence and superconscious samadhi of all enlightened beings, liberated and ascended masters, seeing, feeling, and hearing this light as it shines, radiates, and resonates within me as a visible pillar of the world, stabilized, supported, and sustained by the brilliant, elegant one, and infinitely sensitive to that invulnerable state of divine I am samadhi. Let's go ahead and repeat it. What we're doing with these mantras, if in case you're new to Samadhi Game, is we're creating forms in consciousness, forms in sound and vision that allow us to pour our consciousness more into alignment with that samadhi self that's within us all, even now, our full samadhi self glimmering like a sun from our hearts. So let's go ahead and give this mantra again, protecting that shining sun of our hearts. Come on. Sublime I am, samadhi that I am, enfolding me now in that mighty, magic, electronic pillar of cosmic light substance. My identification with its magnificent humility and thoughtful creativity, so powerful and complete, that I artfully and magically alter every polarity with healing unity. Within this majestic pillar of light blazes that love as the violet compassionate flame. In, through, and around my etheric, mental, emotional, and physical bodies, effortlessly dissolving, consuming, transmuting, and reconciling the dualities of my human ego, charging my world and all I contact with the tangible substance, living awareness and conscious activity. What is that tangible substance? I'm just going to stop us for a moment. That tangible substance is the substance of love. When you feel it boiling, ebullient on the heart, it's real, it's tangible, it's a thing. Let's go on. Tangible substance, living awareness and conscious activity, the presence and superconscious samadhi of all enlightened beings, liberated and ascended masters, seeing, feeling, and hearing this light as it shines, radiates, and resonates within me as a visible pillar of the world, stabilized, supported, and sustained by the brilliant, elegant One, and infinitely sensitive to that invulnerable state of divine I Am Samadhi. One more time through. Sublime I Am Samadhi that I am, enfolding me now in that mighty, magic, electronic pillar of cosmic light substance. My identification with its magnificent humility and thoughtful creativity, so powerful and complete, that I artfully and magically alter every polarity with healing unity. Within this majestic pillar of light blazes that love as the violet compassionate flame. In, through, and around my etheric, mental, emotional, and physical bodies, effortlessly dissolving, consuming, transmuting, and reconciling the dualities of my human ego, charging my world and all I contact with a tangible substance, living awareness, and conscious activity, the presence and superconscious samadhi of all enlightened beings, liberated and ascended masters, seeing, feeling, and hearing this light as it shines, radiates, and resonates within me as a visible pillar of the world, stabilized, supported, and sustained by the brilliant, elegant One, and infinitely sensitive to that invulnerable state of divine I Am Samadhi. Let's go ahead and give our Om together, rubbing our hands together, getting some energy going into the palms. There are different chakras throughout the body. The palms are one of the chakras, or two of the chakras. Let's get them warmed up and then take it from here. Om. Continue with the mantra, just one last line. Eternity is my home. I do all that is necessary to actualize this ever-fresh realization and organize my life around it. And as we complete this mantra, we can visualize our bodies surrounded by streams of light, strengthened, intensified around us. You can feel it so. When we give these mantras, we can actually really feel as though what we're saying is true, already done, already accomplished. The call compels the answer. The answer is now. Not later, but now. So thank you for joining us for this first mantra today. We're only going to give a short session today in this mystical morning, trying to find the very depths of love through this mysticism, which is always within us as samadhi. Going into that samadhi and trying to interpret it, trying to hear its voice to us, its words, its counsel, its direction. It's really a lovely practice. Let's go ahead and do heartfelt, tangible samadhi. Sometimes you'll see people taking out their pendulum and holding it over food and saying, do I want to eat this food? And watching the pendulum swing left or swing right. Well, we can do that with our hearts. Our hearts are the ultimate pendulum. Our hearts are the ultimate telltale sign of everything we do, whether we go left or whether we go right or whether we go straight ahead or whether we step a step backwards. So Let's culture our hearts now. Hold on for 1 second. Let me see who's at the door.
Good morning.
I apologize.
Oh, you want to get in the back door?
Yeah.
Okay, great. No problem. Ready?
Could you open the back door for him, please?
So let's go ahead and intensify the feeling on the heart, this heartfelt, tangible samadhi. This is on page 18 of those who have your own copies open on your own devices. And here we go, together. O Great Spirit, O mighty I Am Samadhi at the center of all creation, radiant with illuminating fire, O heartfelt parent of all suns and suns, pour forth that life-giving power and fan the spark of that divinity on the altar of my heart. Amplify and magnify this spark by the fire breath of the whole I Spirit into the potent God flame that I am. Oh, the shimmering fountain of life that I hear, feel, smell, taste, and see within me. I choose this constant cascade of liquid light, active to receiving its shimmering, directive radiance, tangibly and powerfully manifest in my experience. I open the innermost temple of love within this evident, ebullient, celestial cosmic fire. I manifest that life and light for our healing and regeneration, letting the breath, height, fullness, and crown of the solar radiance of the sun behind the sun appear. I stand forth. Revealed in and through me is the neutral witness, that Christos, Krishna, Buddha, Allah, Pharaoh, Monarch, Divine Mother, Father, Son, Conscious Awareness. I am the visible, audible, and tangible flame of eternal life, breathing the scintillating pranachi from the source to the root of my being. Liquid rays of light flooding my chakras, seated upon the lotus thrones of love, molten gold of enlightenment, shivering its ascension up my spine, crowning my awareness with the diamond rays of attainment. As the white fire being of my heart, I dynamically emanate and transmit this audible, tangible, fragrant, delectable, and visible substance of living samadhi as creativity and direction. I am a sun in the palace of the shining void, this temple, a glistening world of infinite space, the process of my transformations, sounding the melodies, harmonies, and rhythms of the great solar symphony. I am the dazzling flame of life, here and now, because I am nowhere else but everywhere forever. I am Samadhi's palpable joy, tactile glory, and felt perfection of boundless being. I am that. I am that. I am that. I am, and here, say your name, the great name that cuts you free today, the name that takes you one step beyond where you've gone before. I am, and again you say that name. I am, and one more time. In embodiment, in embodiment, in embodiment, I am oneness lived. There's the tantra. There's the tantra for you. To have to live the oneness, to bring that oneness into physical manifestation, no longer just out there as a concept, but actually lived full. Columbus Day. He showed the world it's worthy to explore, not to be afraid. Now the world is not flat, it is round. Molten gold enlightenment, he had samadhi. Yes, yes, indeed. Thank you for those comments. So we're giving the samadhi game. We're giving these mantras which take us outside of the old world consciousness and into the new world consciousness. Always new, always fresh, always mystical, always the unknown. Moving towards that horizon, that ideal, that beautiful ideal that we can all aspire to. Our pipe dreams are important. To hold those pipe dreams out there for all to see is important. Rather than just living in the mundane consciousness of the footstool kingdom, we want to live as kings and queens, pharaohs, directors of our own life, our own destiny. And so we give these samadhi game mantras to inspire us, embolden us to live that way. And mark my words, you take these samadhi game mantras at your own risk. They will change your life. Love changes everything. And this is these are the words of love, mystical love. Let's go ahead and go on and give another affirmation here. I'd like to take us actually through to the third chapter. I'd like to advance us all the way through to this alchemical momentum that we can invoke as rhythmic mantra. I'd like to continue to work with the same square we worked with a few days ago, creation and destruction, and our abiding quality of samadhi will be life. So creation, destruction, and life. When we come to three, there'll be areas in these mantras where we need to insert those terms in. This is the working with the process in, if you're not familiar with it yet, this is a process that we teach in Samadhi Game Tribe. And it's a process called enlightenment with squares. It allows us to see the dual human ego full on, to actually embrace it rather than have it sneak around and be a sort of a hidden creature in our lives. So let's go ahead and give this ruby ray power and violet compassionate transmutation, a very powerful mantra that combines the ideas of the divine identity we find in the first chapter of Samadhi Game, along with the shadow work that we do in the second chapter of Samadhi Game. This is the third chapter. This is on page 57, if you're reading from your own books. Come on, let's get on with this mantra. It's really good. Adorable I am, Samadhi that I am, that supreme ruler of ruby ray power and the unconditional love of the violet flame that dispassionately dissolves, consumes, transmutes, and reconciles all phases of the wheel of karma in pure enjoyment. In resonant formation with the ascended Paramhansa Yogananda, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada and Hans Baba. I'm just going to stop for a second. We have all these names here written in gold. If you're new to Samadhi Game, these names written in gold, it's code. You can change these names. You don't have to say them. It's nice if you want to say them with us. It resonates us across the planet when we say these words together. But this is for you to decide which masters, which goddesses and gods, which friends down the street have inspired you beyond measure. And then use those names to actually draw that higher frequency into your own life. Let's go ahead and back to this mantra. Swami Prabhupada and Hans Baba, Sir Laugh-A-Lot, Saint Germain and Portia, Elohim, Arcturus and Victoria, Archangel Zadkiel and Holy Amethyst, Omri Tas, ruler of the violet planet, the great cosmic light and mighty lords of the flame from Venus, the hierarchs of the elements, earth, air, fire, water, and Akasha, Virgo and Pelor, Aries and Thor, Prince Oramasis and Diana, Neptune and Loara, Zeus and Tara. I'm just going to explain that a little bit more. People say, what? Who's Aries and Thor? Prince Oramasis and Diana, Neptune and Loara, and who's Omri Tas? Well, these are names that, for me, always embodied the different hierarchs of the elements. They say fire, they say air, they say water, and they say earth, but not as impersonal images, as personal images. So these impersonal deities of the elements take on personality, just like mountains take on personality. The Himalayas, they have a certain feel to them, which is a personality. Same thing with the elements. So we name these beings of the elements as personalities, so we have a more personal connection with them. And it feels more informal than just this great mass of fire that we have to deal with. Okay, let's go back to the mantra. Together, I fly towards the secret sky of ruby ray power and the violet compassionate transmutation, and cause 100 veils of illusion to fall each moment. As Portia, Saint Germain, Claire Delisle, Lanello, El Moria, Kuthumi, and the Maha Chohan, I say, thus far but no further, I release the transfiguring action of Ruby Ray power and the measureless mercy of the Vata Flame under the cause of Hector, record and memory of that tempting and tormenting ego, including the fears and the desires of creation and destruction. It is transmuted and consumed on the instant in love and life. I will it done by the power of love and life. I open and charge the golden pink radiance of divine love in its most powerful, dynamic activity into the world and all mankind, and into the world of my mind, feelings, and body, my home, and all my spiritual, sexual, social, recreational, romantic, personal, family, domicile, dietary, health, medical, career, financial, business, political, and legal affairs. All compassionate, I am Samadhi that I am. I am the eternal, complete, and unconditional forgiveness and command of all dual human ego created down the corridors of past, present, and future. All transmuting, I am Samadhi that I am. I open through me now that violet consuming flame of divine love and compassion. I identify and surrender my human self-concern and all patterns and habits of duality, appetites for illusion, fears and desires of creation and destruction. I dissolve and transmute them all, cause, effect, record of memory, past, present, and future. I replace them all with the fullness of myself, including life. That state of perfect samadhi, held with full dominion here, now, and forever. As the all-seeing I am of samadhi, my very own neutral witness and silent watcher of all mankind, Elohim Cyclopea, the great karmic board in Saint Germain, I search the entire karmic record of all my past lives and its presentation in this life now. I identify, transmute, and transform all latent and or active returning mental, emotional, physical, and astrological debts and patterns deprived of frozen children, such as the frozen child process is written here. You can follow that. We're just going to go ahead and say creation and destruction. And then continuing on with seemingly affecting all or influencing any person, place, condition, process, or thing that I have ever wronged at any time, including, and here you can name your enemies. And here is the frozen child process. I'm going to page us through it. You should read this. It's really quite interesting. And then use it as often as possible, taking yourselves back to those knots in consciousness that froze you. It doesn't have to be as a child. It could be as an adult. But it freezes you like and as a child. And then continuing on with Ruby Ray power and Vedic compassionate transmutation, I am the full understanding and complete self-mastery over the causes and cores of these so-named conditions of seeming limitation, as well as all seeming yet to be named. By the law of forgiveness and grace that I am, I see clearly into the shells of the dual human ego consciousness and its resulting situations. I am Ruby Ray power and Vedic compassionate transmutation, blazing through the cause, effect, record of memory of these snakeskins. Here and now, reconciling limitations born from fear and desire, and ascending into the perfection of my unique I am presence, samadhi, and sexual essence. As the omniscient yoga of oneness that I am, I reach into the storehouse of my causal body with my great and loving arms of light, drawing forth 10 times more substance of life than was misqualified. Of that life substance, I fashion a unique healing form of a sacred fire, a perfectly suited antidote for each shadowy shape, process, and condition. I send it forth this instant to balance tenfold every debt to every part of life. I give thanks, and I accept it done this hour in full power. As the omnipotent purpose that I am, I dissolve, consume, transmute, and reconcile all karmic momentums of my past, present, and future. All distorted shapes of duality, doubts, fears, desires, and seeming forces of opposition within my own world and cross-currents of the human ego throughout the earth. I now cast all shadowy shapes created of the dual human ego, cause, effect, record of memory, into the boiling sea and consuming fire of forgiveness. I'm just laughing here. I've got to stop for a second. I took my daughter to see Little Mermaid, and years and years ago. And I remember the scene towards the end of the movie where I think it's Ursula, I can't remember. I think it's Ursula, her name. She's the demon goddess. She was trying to steal. Ursula was the name of. I don't know. Anyway, she was trying to steal her voice, the Little Mermaid's voice. And at the end, she was very angry and wanted to destroy Ursula and her boyfriend. And she got this voice about her that was so memorable to me. She just was commanding, you know, the sea to rise up and swallow up this little boat. And that's kind of how we have to get when we're giving the Samadhi game mantras. We have to get really dramatic like this and pull it down. We're pulling down into matter the spiritual essence, this mystical essence, into form. And when we do it with our voices, we can really garner some drama. So let's, exactly. Jamie says, Ursula used to give me nightmares. Well, it's time, Jamie, that we stand up stronger than Ursula. If the demons and discarnates, the fears and the desires, those frequencies of the dual human ego can frighten us, we need to get bigger than them. We need to know ourselves as the samadhi that is larger than them all. And we can speak larger and more with more authority than Ursula ever did. So let's go. Let's get us back to this and let's say these words. As the omnipotent presence that I am, I dissolve, consume, transmute, and reconcile all karmic momentums of my past, present, and future. All distorted shapes of duality, doubts, fears, desires, and seeming forces of opposition within my own world, and cross currents of the human ego throughout the earth. I now cast all shadowy shapes created of the dual human ego, cause, effect, record, and memory, into the boiling sea and consuming fire of forgiveness, reconciling, replacing, and depolarizing, healing and making art of the frequencies of the dual human ego with the eternal, perfect, and ascended shape and feeling tone of the healthy, playful, and creative I am Samadhi. I flash ruby ray power and violet lightning of divine love through all my spiritual, sexual, social, recreational, romantic, personal, family, domicile, dietary, health, medical, career, financial, business, political, and legal affairs. As the omnipresent void of eternity that I am, I capture the brains, bodies, and consciousness of every individual associated with these affairs, including, and here you can name those individuals that you're associated with it. And that's right. We're actually casting out, when we do this, this type of mantra, this type of invocation is casting out in the name of Samadhi, in the frequency of Samadhi, as we stand in and as Samadhi, we cast out those demons and discarnates, those lesser frequencies of the dual human ego. We put them into their place, and then we hold them in a very artistic form, in a healing form. They even love it when we do this, because it gives organization to all of creation. So let's go ahead now and go back to the mantra and say, I capture the brains, bodies, and consciousness of every individual associated with these affairs, including those that we've named, producing that purity, purpose, perfection, protection, and pointed direction. I illumine them all by the light of that truth, dharma, and authenticity, and keep that light forever self-sustained in the eternal glory and victory of that love. That mystical Monday morning love. By the power, the activity, and the authority, the omniscience, omnipotence, and omnipresence that I am, I speak to my untransmuted karma and to every discordant or limiting condition, judgment, deprived, or frozen child that would seek to repolarize and imbalance my dual human ego, including the fears and the desires of we're using creation and destruction. Dissolve, consume, transmute, and reconcile by the ruby ray and the invited light of life. Dissolve, consume, transmute, and reconcile by the ruby ray and the radiant divided light of life. Dissolve, consume, transmute, and reconcile by the ruby ray and the radiant divided light of life. I see you in process and perfect now. My world is filled overflowing with a balance, perfection, and presence of I am Samadhi. I strip from you, O thou noble appearance of duality, all power to limit, harm, or disturb me, to judge, confuse, or intimidate me, and I empower you as the artistic and healing frequencies of existence that do reconcile all opposites of duality, past, present, and future. I walk henceforth as the quenchless fire of the shining void. And I know nothing. I do not know. And hence, I am free. I am now and forever free. And we stand in fire. Just like this depiction of this Buddha, flames of fire bursting off our skin all around us. This tangible, tactile thing of love. Burning as a fire, as a protective envelope, the Wei Qi, the Chinese call it, and free, and free. Hallelujah, I am free. And so there's our half hour. There's our short samadhi session this Monday morning. I'd give more today. I'd just keep going. I am totally into it. You can keep going if you like, but I have some other things that are pressing me today that I'm going to step into and do those. So must go. But I want to thank you all for coming to Samadhi Game. We're here on Mondays and Wednesdays on a regular basis. I've been getting to a Saturday morning broadcast as well, so check in on Saturday mornings. That's Mountain Time, Saturday mornings. I do it pretty much the same time, 7 o'clock for music and 8:30 for the processing and affirmations. Check in for that. We have events coming up. In December, I think we're going to try to schedule something in December, another 8 days of Samadhi meditation. Keep your eyes open on the events page on Samadhi Game Tribe. If you haven't already done so, check it out, Samadhi Game Tribe there on Facebook, and like it and become get the automatic updates and things that happen there on Samadhi Game Tribe. And also my personal webpage, Gregory Brinkley. On Facebook, I do a lot of posting there. So, and it's a lot of it's all about Samadhi Game. Download your free copies of Samadhi Game, and if you feel inclined, you can contribute to the Samadhi Game tribe and community at the contribution link on samadhigame.com. All right, I'm going to leave you with some more mystical harp music, and enjoy the morning. And I will see you Wednesday morning. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.